I'm on my way home from my parents. I'm in a carriage to myself. I thought I'd show you something of my journey. We're on the tube, but it's a suburban tube. The seats are laid out very differently on the tube that runs through the centre of London.
Oh,
please. Keep your feet up, please. It's very tempting, actually. Take your feet up. My shoes are clean. As you can see, it's raining. And we are still travelling through Buckinghamshire countryside. Again, it's a very small village, but it's commuter country, so people have the money to live there in big houses and not be too far out of London. Not many people doing the trip on a Sunday afternoon, of course. I imagine that car park would be full on a weekday. People are going to get on now, so I may just leave you be. Just gives you an idea of what it's like travelling on the underground outside of London. Still my private carriage. Now stations like this, even though they're technically on the underground, they're not underground stations. Well, as you can see, they are not underground. But they have other stops. They have other trains, overland trains stop at them as well. Whereas when you get into town, an underground station usually is just that, unless it's tied in with the mainline station. Ooh. You can mostly now just see the reflections because we're going through trees.
Thank you.
journey that takes best part of 50 minutes. Another small station. Where are we? Britnesford? Chalfont?
Oh, Chalfont and Latton.
Oh no, Chorley Wood. I can't read, it's such a sad case.
Again, this is very much firmly in the stockbroker belt. Big houses around here, lots of money.
Still, good for them. Get to live out in the country and commute in every day. That was an overland train going past. I recognise colours just because I know them. Well, I think things were actually buried in... Oh, there we go. I was going to say things were buried in tunnels. Of course, they flat down the land, so... If you're going through a hill, you're running through tunnels. Going over them, it's still screened by things like trees. So you can't see, but I know the route. In the winter, you'd be able to see a lot more. We're going through fields at the moment. The longest route you get to see houses and swimming pools. Trust me, that is not common in England.